In this screencast, I'll show you how to calculate the efficiency for an array of fins. The calculations are more complex than those for a single fin. However, once you understand the analysis behind the calculations, it should be a little easier. Let's start by looking at an array of fins. So we define L as the length of a fin right here. T is the thickness of the fin, W is this width back into the paper, and A sub B is the area of the exposed base. In other words, the area of the total base minus the fin area that's attached to it. So here we'll assume rectangular fins so that the fin area attached to the base, so that is just W times T. So the definition of efficiency is the actual heat transfer rate, and we're going to call this Q total, divided by the maximum heat transfer rate. And here, the maximum heat that could be transferred would be if the convective driving force were maximum, i.e. the temperature difference was the highest. Then the temperature of the entire array would have to be at the base temperature. Our actual heat transfer rate is the heat transfer from the fins plus the heat transfer from the exposed base, as shown in a previous screencast. So what we're looking for is the overall efficiency, which we'll define as this eta sub O. So two ways to do this. The first is to find the total heat transfer rate, which we did in that previous screencast, and divide it by the maximum, which is this convective heat transfer coefficient, times the total area, times theta sub B, which we'll be calling TB minus T infinity. And our total area here is equal to the total area of the fins, the number of fins times the area of the fin, plus the area of the exposed base. However, another way to do it is to simplify the expression for the efficiency using equations for both parts, i.e. the Q sub T and the Q sub max. And as you'll see, this second approach offers a lot more flexibility since it allows us to solve for the total heat transfer rate for a number of different systems very easily. Let's start with the expression for the total heat transfer rate. So that means that our Q sub T is equal to the number of the fins times the efficiency of the fin times the convective heat transfer coefficient times the area of a fin times our theta sub B. So that's the heat transfer rate of the fins. And we're going to add to it, again, the heat transfer rate of the exposed base. Now, our Q max, which is equal to H times this A sub T times our theta sub B. So now let's divide the two. And you can see right away that we can get rid of this theta sub B. So let's look at the top of this efficiency equation. So we will pull out an H, remembering that A sub T is equal to N A sub F plus the area of the base. We can write this. So all I did was make a substitution into there. And now we're going to pull out the A sub T and simplify it. And hopefully you're seeing that we can simplify this even more. And now let's go back to our expression for our efficiency and look at what happens. These two cancel out, and so we're left with an efficiency. One of the things you can do is you can find this total heat transfer rate from the original definition of the efficiency. So this is just going to be equal to this overall efficiency times our Qmax, or this eta sub O times H times the total area times theta sub B or TB minus T infinity. And finally, we can go back from a thermal circuit standpoint, where our resistance for this, which is equal to theta sub B divided by Q sub T. I mean, this is the same thing. So Q sub T is just equal to TB minus T infinity divided by this resistance. And that seems like exactly what we showed before. However, this is very handy when we have more resistances than just a fin. What if there's convection on the other side of the base? What if there's conduction through the base? Then we can put together a thermal circuit such that our Q is equal to our T infinity 1, which is convection on one side of the system, minus T infinity 2, which is the convection on the other side of the system, times the sum of the resistances. And now our total resistances are equal to, again, 1 over the convective heat transfer coefficient on the other side times the base. Now this area is the total area of the base, because remember, we're coming from the other side, plus now we have conduction through that base. So that's L, the length through the base, times the thermal conductivity of the base, times again the total area of the base. And we add to that the resistance that we just found, 1 over that overall efficiency times that H, and this time it's H2, times the total area. So if we look at a picture of that, what we're looking at is something like this. So we have an H1 here, a T infinity 1, and then we have conduction through here, and then now we have our fins, which give us that final resistance. So this is a lot easier once you find a thermal resistance for the entire array of fins.